So, we'll be beginning with how to begin our app, and I would recommend you to begin your app with a template which is defined outright here. So, if you see that this is what is importing from the library Shiny, and this is the app template which you can get it from the console page directly, app.template. Now, UI.fluid page, server function, input output, and Shiny app UI server. So this is the fluid page part of it, wherein you can render the input and the output function. And I would recommend you to use this fluid page wherever you wanted to make any entry to the command line prompt to your web UI page. So just in suppose if you write hello world in there, so you'll get displayed like hello world as a server would listen to it. Now, more importantly, whatever input you are defining, those inputs you need to define in the fluid page part of it. So, in the syntax of fluid page, input and output functions can be defined. Now, the slider input which is there, if you wanted to make any basically a line wherein you wanted to choose a number, you can define it in the fluid page section. So suppose as slider input id is equal to a num value you wanted to enter, label choose a number. So this is the label which you are getting over here. This is like a header to what you are making, and then value equals to 25, min equals to 1, max equals to 100, and then choose a number. So basically what happens, so if this is the value 25, you get it from here, and then min equals to 1 and then max equals to 100. Okay, so you get a slider over here. You have defined the input as a slider. You can also simultaneously define multiple inputs like button, checkbox group input, date input, data range input, password input. All those are available in the R Shiny library, wherein you can import them and can utilize into the format you wanted to make. So now what is important is what you can do out of this input function. Say suppose as I told earlier, if you are choosing this slider over here and different values you are choosing, say suppose 25, 35, 55, then and this is the K graph which is being generated out of it. So if you choose a number like 35, 25, and 55, so you get different clusters like the K map which is being generated for corresponding to these values which you are choosing. So now this is the box plot output, the K means graph which is you are generating through the output function, and the input is in what you are defining in the slider input function from here. So as I told you just keep the template for all of the graphs, for all of the layouts which you wanted to make for your inputs function, and then add element as the arguments, as whatever you wanted to define these arguments in the input function can be defined in the fluid page section of it. So just whatever arguments you are giving in the input, slider, button, checkbox, group output, data input, data range input, password, and there are plenty more in the R Shiny app where you can see in from there, you can define in the input part of it, and in there from that input part you can generate the output as the R function would render it. So that is how the app template would be. Now I would be explaining you how to add elements as argument to the fluid page, more importantly, in detailed way into the second section of it. Yeah.